basic electrical concept. Basic concept are in each plant, the mechanical movement of different equipment is caused by an electric prime mover or motor. Electrical power is divided from either utilities or internal generator and is distributed through transformers to deliver usable voltage levels. Electricity is found in two common forms, AC or DC. AC is the alternating current and DC is the direct current. Electrical equipments can either of the AC or DC form of electrical energies. The section of energy sources for equipment depends on its application requirements. Each energy source has its own merits and demerits. Industrial AC voltage are roughly divided as LV or low voltage and HV as high voltage with frequency of 50 to 60 Hz. An electrical circuit has the following three basic components irrespective of its electrical energy form: voltage or volt, ampere or amps, or resistance and ohm. Voltage is defined as the electrical potential difference that causes electrons to flow. Current is defined as the flow of electrons and is measured in amperes. Resistance is defined as the opposition to the flow of electrons and is measured in ohm. All three are bounded together with Ohm's law, which gives the following relationship between the three: V is equal to IR. Let's talk about power. In DC circuit, power or watt is simply a product of voltage and current, where P equals to VI, where power equals to voltage and current. For AC circuit, the formula holds true for purely resistive current. However, for the following type of AC circuits, power is not just a product of voltage and current. Let's talk about apparent power. Apparent power is the product of voltage and ampere, or VA or KVA is known as apparent power. Apparent power is total power supplied to a circuit inclusive of true and reactive power. Let's talk about real power. Real power or true power is the power that can be converted into work and is measured in watt. Let's talk about reactive power. If the circuit is of an inductive or capacitive type, then the reactive component consumes power and cannot be converted into work. This is known as reactive power and is denoted by the unit VAR. The relationship between power as apparent power VA equals to V cross A or voltage cross ampere. True power or say watt equals to VA cross phi. Reactive power is equals to VA cross sin phi. Let's talk about power factor. Power factor is defined as the ratio of real power to apparent power. The maximum value it can carry is either 1 or 100%, which would be obtained in a pure resistive circuit. Power factor equals to 2 power upon apparent power. Type of circuits. There are only two types of circuits, series and parallel. A series circuit is defined as a circuit in which the element in a series carry the same current, while voltage drop across each may be different. A parallel circuit is defined as a circuit in which the element in parallel have the same voltage but the current may be different. So friends, if you are liking this video, don't forget to press the like button. Also don't forget to subscribe to YouTube channel. So let's talk about transformer. A transformer is a device that transforms voltage from one level to another. Transformer working is based on mutual EMF induction between two coils, which are magnetically coupled. When an AC voltage is applied to one of the winding, called as primary, it produces alternating magnetic flux in the core made up of magnetic material, usually some form of steel. The flux is produced by a small magnetizing current which flows through the winding. The alternating magnetic flux induces an electromotive force or EMF in the secondary winding, mechanically linked with the same core, and appears as a voltage across the terminal of this winding. Cold-loaded gain-oriented or CRGO steel is used as the core material to produce a low reluctance, low loss flux path. The steel is in the form of varnish laminations to reduce eddy current flow and loss on account of this. There is a very simple and straight relationship between the potential across the primary coil and the potential induced in the secondary coil. The ratio of the primary potential to the secondary potential is the ratio of number of turns in each and is represented as follows: N1 upon N2 or N1 divided by N2 equals to V1 divided by V2. Current induced in transformer when the transformer is loaded, then the current in is inversely proportional to the voltage and is represented as follows: N1 divided by N2 equals to V1 upon V2 equals to I2 upon I1.